Sometimes you start praying and then you pray for 10 minutes. It looks as if you want to die. That's when the journey began. If you can cover another 40 minutes, you discover that maybe you have dealt with something that is of the flesh. The next time you come, you are no longer stopping at 10 minutes. You have gone to 50 minutes. And then you stretch. The moment you reach 50 minutes, you become weak. Those are alarm systems of the flesh. If you want to deal with the flesh and bring out the power of your ordination, you will not stop when your flesh says to stop. You will stop after you have an encounter. Because what stops our prayer is not time. What stops our prayer are the encounters that we have with God. That's why when you mature, you stop praying with time. You pray with encounters. You will not stop until a word comes. Do you not read about the prophet? You hear that the word of the Lord came to me. The word of the Lord came to me. The word of the Lord came to me. That's when they stop praying. They stop praying when feedback begins to come from heaven. But you see, we have not mastered how to win the battle of flesh. So we just pray with time. 1 hour, 2 hours. Wake up! If you want to transit, you must break out of time. And the way to break out of time is to labor on the altar until everything that stops you from praying is broken off.
My engine must work. Sadiambe, Sadiambe, Tetembe, Kabanda Pata, Akua Katamanang. be overtaken. I push my spirit. My spirit must have dominion over the soul. I will grow until the dominion of the spirit comes upon the soul. I will grow. I can continue like this. I know the power in my spirit. I grow. There is a place where prayer power is. Prayer power. Oh God. Badangata. Yamba. Yamba. Datata. Yamba. Datata. I come on to Kotoko, Kanda Katia, Tanapata, Akwanda.